Starship aiming to perform its first orbital launch later this month, SpaceX are once again attempting to create history. But in order for this first test flight to be a success, SpaceX has to be sure that the 29 Raptor engines on the bottom of Super Heavy will fire without any significant problems. Building a spaceship is not an easy task. A lot of testing was required before launch, until the FAA allowed SpaceX to test a spacecraft if it couldn't complete 75 tasks. SpaceX should be able to fire first on rough terrain without major problems with its 33 Raptor engines. Join us as we bring you, why is 33 Raptor engine testing a big problem for SpaceX and Elon Musk? Let's expose it all in today's episode. SpaceX is now looking forward to completing its orbital test flight. It will be a test flight unparalleled as a fully equipped spacecraft, will generate almost twice as much thrust as Saturn V, than the most powerful rocket ever built to match the thrust of a super heavy rocket. The boosters have 33 Raptor boosters that will propel a Tier 2 spacecraft into orbit. For this test flight to go well, a lot of booster tests need to be done, and it's been a really big deal since the last 7 booster explosion. Elon Musk also admitted that, in the future he would not conduct laboratory launch tests, with all 33 engines at once. With the ability to start by filling booster 7, with about 2,500 tons of liquid nitrogen for the first time. SpaceX can temporarily fill one of its liquid oxygen or orbital methane tanks, with nitrogen to fill booster 7 with about 3,500 tons of nitrogen. At least according to the SpaceX website, this nitrogen weighs about the same as a 3,400-ton propellant designed to lift super heavy loads. If this entire test is successful, SpaceX will likely conduct more than one wetsuit workout. Eventually filling booster 7 with approximately 2,900 tons of cryogenic oxygen and 500 tons of cryogenic methane. While the Raptor engine is much more reliable, this is a test on a completely different scale than what SpaceX has done before. As a precaution, the Super Heavy B-7 can use far less fuel in most static fire tests, but a fully fueled static fire simulating most pre-ignition conditions is likely one of the latter. A big target for any fully boosted static fire campaign. The 33 Raptor 2 engine will likely burn about 25 tons or about 55,000 pounds of fuel per second, is 50% more powerful than NASA's Saturn lunar rocket, and produces 7 times more thrust than a Falcon 9, but requires significant amount of energy and fuel. The fact is that the Soviet N-1 rocket is the only other rocket that is about the same size as a spacecraft, and has a similar layout of the 30NK-15 engine in 2 rings. When Booster 4 lights up all 29 of its engines, it will produce a level of thrust 7 times greater than the Falcon 9. And this number is set to increase as the Raptor engine is upgraded. The only other rocket that comes close to this is the Soviet N-1 rocket. It was a similar size to Starship and also featured a similar layout of 30 engines. But sadly, it only performed 4 launches, all of which ended in failure. Many of the failures were caused by explosive engines, which led to a chain of other problems during launch. Unfortunately, however, each of the 4 launch attempts failed. With the second crashing onto the launch pad shortly after launch, triggering one of the largest man-made non-nuclear explosions in human history, and causing multiple failures. Another problem arose when the N-1 engine chain blast program was discontinued in 1974 and officially discontinued in 1976. The innovative SpaceX is expected to shut down a failed engine before turning into a grenade. In fact, N-1 was not there either. Problems with the engine were discovered even before launch, as there were no adequate test facilities in the USSR. With much more advanced computer systems now, SpaceX will hopefully be able to shut down a failing engine before it turns into a grenade. The engine problems on the N-1 were never discovered prior to launch, because the Soviets didn't have a large enough testing facility to static fire the massive N-1's first stage. This is a problem that SpaceX is hoping to solve with its Boca Chica facility. But it's not just the rocket itself that could cause problems during a static fire. The entire launch infrastructure surrounding the rocket plays a crucial role in keeping the rocket safe. Normally, launch pads use a flame diverter to deflect the intense exhaust away from the rocket and the launch pad. But SpaceX is taking a much riskier approach with Starship. The current design of the orbital launch pad in Boca Chica features no flame diverter at all, and the booster sits just 20 meters above the ground. And so, when the engines fire, an enormous amount of heat and energy is sent directly onto the concrete below. Elon Musk calls this stage zero, and it's at least as complex as a booster or ship. When the Raptor's 33 high-powered engines are activated, even nominal pre-tests are likely to produce large fireballs that can engulf the rear of super-heavy static fire boosters. That Raptors are generally considered smaller and shorter. However, when turned off, it still creates significant fireballs, creating another potential source of damage to sensitive equipment in or within the Booster 7 section. These super-heavy aero shrouds can be as important to surviving a static fire as they are to survival takeoff and landing. This is the problem that SpaceX is trying to solve with the Super Heavy. It should be noted that there are several specialized Starbase launchers. A launch pad that typically uses a flame deflector to deflect intense exhaust gases from rockets and launchers. Instead, SpaceX built a separate steel base and water-cooled booster design to withstand the fury of the Super Heavy engines without scattering the rocket's poles to the ground after burning up. On the face of it, SpaceX actually has over 10 years of experience building and operating launchers and deflectors for the McGregor, Texas test site. NASA's own developments relied heavily on these technologies and strategies to test and rapidly build more rockets to fly. It's safe to say that a super heavy craft larger than anything we've seen before requires far more deflection to sustain the equivalent of three or more super heavy. Finally, the deadweight of the aircraft when all 33 engines are running is another factor that SpaceX takes into account. Thrust washers at the bottom of the booster are designed to transfer all of the engine power to the booster wall, gradually increasing it to full power. A similar super ignition takes about 2 seconds to ignite each plunger. Redundancy is one reason why there are many engines, not just a few larger ones. If multiple engines fail to fire during takeoff or landing, the rocket is not destroyed as the remaining engines can spin or throttle to compensate for the loss of thrust. So when will we see the first full-fledged static fires in Super Heavy? The current Super Heavy B7 is back to the launch site with a factory upgrade. SpaceX is busy with Super Heavy and Starship 24 testing. So far, SpaceX has only performed a few pressure tests on Booster 7, their most complete Super Heavy booster. These tests usually involve filling the booster's tanks with cryogenic liquid to simulate the temperatures and pressures it will experience during a flight. But the most realistic test that needs to be completed before Booster 7 ever lifts off will be a complete static fire, using all 33 of its engines. So let me tell you that August is going to be even more exciting, as the full testing of 33 Raptors is guaranteed to be very exciting. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, to make sure you can subscribe. If you have any crazy idea what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we will see if we can get the, and thanks again for watching and goodbye.